the Valvoline Forest Rally Championship in association with Motorsport Ireland and Quilcha.
Welcome to Mallow for the Jim Walsh Cork Forestry Rally, round four of the Valvoline Forest Rally Championship. Gary Jennings comes here with a 9-point lead in the championship over Colin Britton, and at the last rally, a mere 21 seconds covered the top five cars, proving what a competitive championship this is.
Yes, with three different winners on the first three events, the competition was really heating up as the championship moved to Cork, where Owen Murphy was hoping to follow his win in the last round with victory on home soil.
This is one that's dear to me, and I've come second here three times now, so I'm really hoping to crack that burden today and win.
Colin, second in the championship, hoping for your first win of the season perhaps today?
It's a long time coming, need to come shortly. but hopefully it'll come, yeah.
Stephen, third overall, a great year for you so far?
Yeah, it's been going good. It started off fairly well in Donegal, we got second, but I suppose the last two rounds we sort of dropped back a wee bit. You know, we're here a bit because of our consistent results, but we're going to really need to push on and get a good result today.
Kevin, bit of a change coming across to forestry?
Obviously the championship wasn't going the way we wanted it to go, so keep our options open, want to try something different, and I've never had the car in the woods, so I said this was a good opportunity to do it.
And I believe your young man Paul is out here today as well.
Yeah, he's out for his first proper rally today. He just done the events to get his licence upgrade, so he's out in Evo 6, so we're more sort of keeping an eye on him now, I think, today than worrying what I'm doing.
Paul, your first ever proper rally. Yes. Tell us a bit about it.
I'm can't wait. I'm looking very forward to it now. Get out, have a day's crack and try and get some mileage in the new car.
Six demanding stages await the competitors of this year's Jim Walsh Forest Rally. But before the event even started, there was a controversial development resulting in the expulsion of one of the frontrunners.
We're here at the start of stage one, and drama has already unfolded as we've learned that championship leader Gary Jennings' car has failed scrutiny. So Pat O'Connell leads out the field from Owen Murphy.
With his father looking from the hedges, Pat O'Connell was first on the road. And while his chances of winning weren't harmed by Gary Jennings' absence, O'Connell would still have preferred to see the Fermanagh man Subaru in his rearview mirror. The former champion went on to hold second after the opening two stages.
3, 2, 1, go! Stack in the one right, the flat five left long.
Next on the road were Owen Murphy and James O'Brien. The local crew bedded in on the first test before opening out a 5-second lead after stage two.
Flat six left continues for 200. 350 up the middle. Flat six left, 150 down. Turn hairpin right around the bales. You'll see them. Turn hairpin right around the bales. Go. 2 red, 100.
A steady run through the opening loop saw Colin Britton hold third place, just 1/10 of a second behind Pat O'Connell.
80. Flat mid over the bump at the junction. Flat mid through the bump at the junction, 130. 5 red opens, 200. 5 red opens, 200. 5 opens, 200. 5 left in and push. 5 left in and push. 100 muddy ahead.
It was a nervy start for Vincent McAree. He's put his Evo 9 on stage one, losing about 30 seconds in the process. The incident seemed to shake the young Monaghan man as he lost another 11 seconds to the pace setters on stage two, leaving him outside the top 10 for the moment. Another unhappy Monaghan crew were siblings Stephen and Suzanne Wright. They held 8th overall in the Mitsubishi Evo 6. Faring better over the opening loop were Enda McNulty and Paul Sheridan, who held 6th place at the break.
So far, so good. One overshoot, but besides that, I'm trying to get back into it because the last two fours I'd done early in the year, we had non-finishes due to breakdown, so we're just getting really into it now. So we're halfway through the year, and this is as far as we got so far, so we're looking forward to the rest of the day, really.
First of two WRCs in the rally was the Impreza of Martin Cairns. The Tyrone man was happy with his morning's work and held fourth overall after the opening loop.
Through the piers and towards square left on the tower.
Good man.
200. Keep right. Absolute one left long, 150.
Kevin Barrett's first time in the woods with his WRC went well enough, and he went sixth quickest over stage one.
Right, 550 up the middle, over bumps, okay. Caution, crest of trees, only 40, slippy braking, bus stop chicane, right entry. 100. 3 right in, 200.
Sadly, recurring clutch problems struck on stage two, and a Maynooth man was forced to retire the Triton Subaru.
Were you enjoying your time on the forest anyway?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. First stage, we had a real good run through the first stage, and I felt fairly comfortable at it, and like, you know, really enjoyed it. Like, you know, it's getting the car sliding about is really enjoyable compared to the tarmac, but look, we'll be back, have another go.
Local brothers Jared and James Lucy slid their Mitsubishi Evo 9 around the first two stages to hold fifth overall after the opening loop. Niall Henry continued to impress on his debut season in the N11 Impreza. He held 10th overall at the break. Starting his first ever rally was Paul Barrett, who could be forgiven for being a little over-eager at times in his Mitsubishi Evo 6.
Five right, past lane, 550. Five right here, 550 to the top.
Lots of competition out there.
Oh yeah, the lads are flying. Like I took one glance at the times, and I say I'll forget that for the day anyway.
First two-wheel drive crew of the event were Shea Power and Paul Collins, who are languishing in 17th place after a spin and puncture on the opening loop.
3, 2, 1, go!
Quickest of the two-wheel drive machines so far was the Toyota Starlet of Shane McGurr, who led the class and held 7th overall after stage 2.
40 turn 6 right, ditch outside. 40 turn 6 right, ditch outside. This is here, 40, 3 left, half long. So 3 left, half long, hairpin right. So 3 left, half long here, hairpin right. 60. So 69, 1 left, 250.
In Class 1, Ken Cullinan and Robert O'Regan were pushing their Opel Corsa to the limit in an effort to catch class leaders Emmett Cronin and Joe O'Brien in the sideways Mark II Escort. In the junior class, Killarney's Dennis Nagel and Donna Crowley held fourth place in the Nissan Micra.
That's why right over Christmas bumps. 400 on the middle lower bumps. 400 on the middle lower bumps. 6 left here now after the pause. 200 over bumps. Turn square right. Square right. 6 left here all the time. Gonna make it. Gonna make it.
Ian Downey and John Brunton held second in the junior class. 14 seconds adrift of Galway crew Dean Raftery and Aileen Kelly, who held the class lead despite some nervy moments in the Honda Civic.
Dean, leading the juniors again. How's your day going so far?
Good. Slippy out there now, but we had a decent run on the first two. There's a lot of places you make up time, but it's tricky out there and just don't want to make a mistake. So happy enough as it is. Like, if we keep it this way, it'd be great.
Pat, first on the road, how's your day going so far?
It's not going too bad now. We dragged a bit on the first stage there, but that second stage now we got into it, so I'm happy enough to be here and in one piece.
A bit of a shocker with championship leader Gary Jennings out.
Yeah, Gary ran into some scrutineering problems, so that's a pity because Gary lifts the whole spirit of the event, so he'll be there for the next one.
Owen, does this lift your championship hopes with Gary Jennings a non-starter?
Yeah, we're not sure what happened altogether, but we'd much prefer to have him here and to be racing with him. But we had a bad first stage, but we had quite a good run there now in the second run. It felt very good, so I don't know anything about times yet or anything, but I assume we're thereabouts.
No, we had a real good run there through the first stage and a good run through the second stage there too. We're happy enough. Car's going well and stages are good, so yep, happy.
Everything's going grand. Stages are very good and fast now. But I think this next stage, the third stage, will be the one. Like, it's there's a lot more driving in it, so it depends who comes out at the quickest. We'll see how we go.
So with the longer third test up next before another service halt, the third stage had the potential to be a real game changer for the drivers. Former champion Pat O'Connell attacked the stage with gusto, but still found himself slipping from second to third place, while Owen Murphy extended his lead at the top by another couple of seconds.
Long opens don't cut. 100. Flat 6 left, 60 hairpin left.
A big push by Colin Britton saw the Tyrone man climb to second, 7 seconds behind Murphy.
Black crest jump forward, he's all flat down here. Steaming over, flat bump and dip, 250 over the bumps. Turn square left, don't cut tight. Down at the red arrow, square left, tight.
Another crew on the up were Enda McNulty and Paul Sheridan, who climbed from 6th to 5th in the Subaru. Fellow Tyrone man Martin Cairns was just 1 second ahead in 4th place. So at the halfway point of the rally, Owen Murphy held the lead ahead of a tightly bunched chasing pack.
With no Gary Jennings here today, Owen Murphy is having his own battle with Colin Britton here at round 4 of the Valvoline Forest Rally Championship. Join us for more after the break.
County Cork for part 2 of the Jim Walsh Forestry Rally, where things were really heating up on this 4th round of the Valvoline Championship. Stung into action by a hard-charging Colin Britton, Pat O'Connell fought back over stages 4 and 5 to retake 2nd place, and now trailed Owen Murphy by just 6 seconds. A stage 5 puncture slowed Murphy's progress slightly, but he was still on course for a much-desired home win.
40! Flat 6 left, 40. 6 right, tight on a small crest, 80 down. Square left plus into 3 wall. Now, square left plus here. 200 up the middle. 2 right into 3 wall.
The tables had been turned on Colin Britton, who slipped from 2nd to 3rd and trails Pat O'Connell by 2 seconds with 1 stage to go.
60. 2 left in, flat, long. 2 left in, 80. Long one rate, 80. Long one rate, 80.
Shane McGurr was still the star of the two-wheel drive class and held 9th overall in the starters.
2 right, 100, and 2 right, 60. 2 right, 40 down only. 40 to hairpin right. Hairpin right at the bottom. Only this is a 2 and then a 40. And then hairpin right. 60. 1 right, 100.
Sadly, Shea Power's rally came to an end when he was forced to retire his escort on stage 4.
Shea, bad luck. What happened to you?
We just cut a corner and we hit a rock and bent decks. It's plain and simple, my own fault. So, let's wait for another day.
James, you're having a bit of trouble, I hear.
Ah, yeah, troublesome day. found stage three very, very loose. We had doing some adjustments on the suspensions and the car got very unstable. In saying that, we had a good run through the next one. And next thing, our front brake caliper, the bolt sheared in it. So we had to take off the wheel and remove the front brake caliper on the right for the last stage. But we got through it with only three brakes. But look, we're here and we'll do the next stage and we'll give it a lash. We're third in class, so that's fine. That's all we'll get now. We won't do any better.
With his stage one spin now a distant memory, Vincent Macquarie had climbed from 19th to 7th in just five stages.
Vincent, how are you getting on?
Not too bad. We were fourth fastest there, so possibility of getting into sixth position, so if we can go faster again on this next stage. So.
Yeah, good. Yeah, we're sort of back on it now. We're just 2 seconds behind Vincent Macquarie on one stage, so we'll have a bit of a push anyway and see how we can do.
Great to see a brother and sister team out.
Ah, yeah, we don't really fall out too often now, so yeah, it works well.
Well, Ian, how are you getting on?
Do you know, I think we're doing all right now. I think we're possibly, are we still 14th class? I think we're 14th class, but we're not far behind third and everything's going absolutely swimmingly. Even he's calling the right notes, which is good.
How are you finding the competition?
It's tight going now. It's been fast ages, but see how it goes in this last one now.
Well, Paul, how's your first rally going now?
It's going brilliant. We had a big, massive moment there in the last stage where we managed to get over it, so happy to be in here at the moment, to be honest with you.
Exciting times here in the forest.
Oh, I love it. Getting the car sideways and like just getting back and or getting up to the pace now was very exciting. Like.
Having been flat out on the stages, Class 1 leader Emmett Cronin showed he was no slouch in the service area too, as he made running repairs to his escort, literally.
Hey, you're having an eventful service.
Jeez. It was all going grand down to the left of stage three and we'd alternator problems and no exhaust problems, so hopefully we'll get it going again and back out for the last stage.
Coming together nicely for the Cronin team as they face the last stage, we turn to the class awards now, where Dennis Nagel finished fourth in the junior class in his Nissan Micra. Daniel Cronin and Sean Duggan brought their Peugeot 206 the third in the junior class. Dubliner Ian Downey had to settle for the runner-up spot in his Opel Corsa with navigator Sean Brunton. They were just 4 seconds slower than junior winners Dean Rafferty and Aileen Kelly from Galway. Ken Cullinan and Robert Regan really put the boot down on the last stage, but had to settle for the runner-up spot in Class 1. Emmett Cronin and Joe O'Brien would have been howling mad if they hadn't made it out of the service, but after a team effort, the local crew took the win in Class 1. Tullamore's Mike Nevin finished second in Class 2 with navigator David Ford. Whistling Dixie en route to Class 2 victory was the escort of John Keneally and Nicky Hegarty. Having led Class 3 all day, local crew Jimmy Dean and Barry Mead were pipped at the post on the last stage and had to settle for second in class and 14th overall. 7 seconds behind fellow Corkman Paul Fitzgerald, who won Class 3 and finished 13th overall.
Middle over bump dip, 250 over bumps. Turn square left tight, don't cut it to bottom. Turn square left tight, don't cut it. And you have a two right out of it, go. Two right, go, now 100.
Alan and James Cummins won Class 4 and finished 23rd overall. James Coleman took 3rd in Class 5 and 18th overall after a dramatic day in the Sherway Forklifts Escort.
Here, a tight 3 left in over bump and 300 down the middle over bumps.
tight. Whoa, you bitch.
Fuck you, come out.
Fuck you. Fucking hell. Square right. Fucking turn square right.
Monaghan crew Michael Conlon and Damien Fleming finished second in Class 5 and 11th overall. Over half a minute ahead were quickest two-wheel drive crew Shane McGurr and Jackie Elliott, who finished 9th overall in the Starless. It was a disappointing non-finish for Paul Barrett's debut rally after mechanical trouble struck on the last stage. James Laverty took 3rd in Class 6 and 12th overall. Also in an Evo 6 were Monaghan's Stephen and Suzanne Wright, who finished 2nd in Class and 8th overall. But taking the Class win were Enda McNulty and Paul Sheridan, who finished 5th overall in the Subaru Impreza. 4 seconds quicker in 4th place was the Impreza WRC of Class 7 winners Martin Carnes and Patrick Bryce. Another consistent drive saw Antrim's Niall Henry and John Roan take 3rd in Class 8 and 10th overall. It was a fine drive also for local crew Gerard and James Lucy, who took 2nd in Class 8 and 7th overall. But taking 1st place in Class 8 and 6th overall were Monaghan brothers Vincent and JP Macquarie. The tables were turned once again at the overall battle, where Pat O'Connell and Mark Wiley had to settle for 3rd place, having been pipped by just 9 tenths of a second by runners-up Colin Britton and Arthur Cairns. They finished 6 seconds behind rally winners Owen Murphy and James O'Brien. Having been so close so many times, the victory was especially sweet for Owen, who finally got the monkey off his back and won his home forestry rally.
Owen, a fantastic win.
Yeah, it's a long time coming. We come second in this rally 3 times, so it was a real hard fought rally today. I mean, the lads are on a crazy mission as well, as I was pushing real hard as well all day, but we had a fantastic day, and we had great grip from our Hankook tyres as well, and couldn't do better.
Colin, a great result, but you just lost out in the last stage.
Yeah, well, we gave it a good run the last stage. We just got Pat there by 0.9 of a second, and we took 3 of 4 in there, but that wasn't enough. We had 8 to take off him. But no, great days rallying, and the pace is tough going out there now, definitely is.
Celebrating a tough day's rally with the two-wheel drive win was Tyrone's Shane McGurr.
Shane, a great win in the two-wheel drive.
Yes, very pleased that everything went well. We had a slight overshoot in the first stage, but the stage is in superb condition, like a brilliant event.
Taking the plaudits after his win in the junior class was Dean Raftree.
Dean, a fantastic result.
Good day out now, and we're happy to get the win. It was tight in the end now, but it's a good day overall, so we're happy.
And forestry seems becoming more and more popular with young men in Ireland.
Yeah, today was the biggest entry for the juniors so far this year, so hopefully it'll continue on to the next round.
So there's confirmation of the results, and after 4 rounds, it's all change on the points table, with Colin Britton now leading after Gary Jennings' exclusion.
It's been a drama-filled day here at the 4th round of the Valvoline Forest Rally Championship. Bad luck for Gary Jennings, but Owen Murphy wins and it strengthens his championship hopes. From us all here in Mallow, it's bye for now.
The Valvoline Forest Rally Championship, in association with Motorsport Ireland and Quilcha.